Hi everyone, and welcome to this week's painting time lapse, which is the zodiac sign of Cancer. Cancer is the fourth zodiac sign in a row, and it belongs in the element of water, so as expected, you will see a lot of blues today. Being a Cancerian myself, this painting is a little bit more personal than usual, so that's how this video's topic came up. Of course, all art is personal. We sit down and create something out of nothing. We actually put a part of ourselves on paper or on canvas, and we are prone to facing failure, self-criticism, doubt, and vulnerability. Those of us who also share online also expose that part of ourselves to anyone who may stop by and take a look. We face unsolicited advice and criticism from others. We let ourselves gain and lose value and worthiness because of numbers and algorithms. We sometimes judge our art according to them as well. All of these things are deeply personal. Art is personal by definition. But some paintings are more personal than others for various reasons, and even though I now realize how many of mine were in that category, this one is the one that made me understand it more. During this zodiac series and for the first three zodiac signs, I have been trying to stay true to the essence of each zodiac sign. I have no idea if I've been successful, and I suppose even if I ask people who belong in those first signs, not everyone will share the same opinion anyway. I can't even know about Cancer either, even if it is my own zodiac sign. I cannot expect from every Cancerian out there to agree with me on the concept and the idea behind this painting. What I know is that while I was trying to come up with the idea and the composition, I had a very different, maybe better understanding of what I want to do with it. I didn't care about the crab, my connection was to the moon. I wanted to come up with an idea that would reflect this connection that I personally feel, that the thing that I know I get affected by the moon, I wanted to put that on the painting. We are being called moon children, and I can feel why. I feel the changes of my mood when the moon changes. I know how it affects me, and it disturbs my soul the same way the moon in the painting disturbs the calmness of the water. I know the magic of the night sky, and the symbolism was extra clear to me for this painting. I also know that not every Cancerian will feel the same or agree with me, but does it really matter? It is personal to me, and that's what art is supposed to be. We cannot expect from everyone to feel the same way we do or agree with us on everything. And on some subjects, there is a way to gain objective insights, but not with art. And that, I think, is what makes art especially personal. In the end, what really matters is that we feel the connection to our own art and we put ourselves out there in a way that feels genuine to us. The rest just follows. Some people will like it, some people will hate it, some won't care, and that's okay. After finishing this painting, or during the process, I was thinking that it's been the same for me in other forms of art as well. I just now realized what exactly I was feeling while creating those paintings in the past. I now realize how different it felt to paint, for example, one of my pets instead of a wild animal. I could feel the connection, I knew what to look for, the tiny things that would make the likeliness real, the expressions and the small things that Rooney and Lina have that would make the painting better. It's the same thing with portraits, when you paint someone you love or you know very well, you know what makes them who they are, you know what will make the viewer realize that it's them. For me, I can also feel the same kind of connection now that I'm painting landscapes of places I know, from photos that I have personally taken. It's very different than taking a photo online from online sites and painting it. It's so much different remembering the moment that you took the photo or knowing the place because you've been there 1,000 times. There is something extra special about that, and I think it's the same kind of connection in different forms. I think it's also why I'm enjoying it so much at the moment. I'm sure it will be more obvious in plein air painting when you're actually capturing a moment and a memory. It's like that painting will also include sounds and smells for the artist. Isn't that extra special? I've only said a few examples here, but I'm sure it's the same in many different ways for many different kinds of art. I haven't experienced all of that. I'm sure I have experienced more, but those things that were the first one that came to my mind when I started thinking about it. And I'm pretty sure, even if we don't see it, even if we can't really put our finger on it, even the viewer of a piece of art might feel something different about the paintings that were created this way. I can't say for sure that this is always the case, but I think that when we create from our heart, from something that we feel connected to, the art is always going to be better than just using the correct techniques and being perfect at something. There is something unique in art that was creating in this way. Now that I have spotted this feeling and I somehow have made sense of it, I also think it is addictive for the artist. I know I keep changing my mind for a lot of things, but so I can't say how I will feel in the future, but right now it really feels like truly creating art when this connection is present. No matter what I'm painting, no matter the style or the medium, it's the feeling that matters. And for one more week, I have no idea if what I said made any kind of sense or if it was in any way useful, but I would be curious to know if you felt the same way and why, when, how did it happen? Hopefully it was useful and hopefully you also liked the painting as well. If you did, please leave a thumbs up before you go and consider subscribing for more videos like this. Remember to hit the bell button if you would like to get notified whenever I upload a new video like this. And yeah, I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, be safe, be happy, and keep going for your dreams. Bye!